The city of San Francisco tomorrow takes up whether to warn its citizens about using cell phones, not as a distraction, but as a possible way to avoid cancer. Experts say scientific studies are causing more concern about long-term cell phone use. KTVU Health and Science editor John Fowler tonight takes a look in our special report.
57-year-old Lafayette real estate broker Ellie Marks suddenly had a grand mal seizure last year after 20 years of intense cell phone use.
Of actually holding that thing to my head 10,000 hours.
One prominent doctor went on record that Marks' cell phone use likely caused his golf ball-sized malignant brain tumor called an oligodendro glioma. We're looking upward in this MRI. It's on the right side of his brain, adjacent to where he held his cell phone. Surgeons removed as much cancer as they could, but now give him 5, maybe 8 years to live.
It's painful. It's horribly painful, yet I want people to know that this is for real.
Because it's no different than holding a gun to your head. I mean, you're killing yourself.
About 90% of people in the Bay Area press cell phones regularly to their heads. Some scientists say evidence is now growing of long-term harm.
We discover the cell phone radiation. One is that it damages DNA.
It's overwhelming that cell phones are causing brain tumors.
Berkeley researcher Lloyd Morgan says telecommunications industry studies are biased and flawed, that other studies suggest a cell phone cancer epidemic.
There is going to be hundreds of millions of people potentially getting brain tumors caused by cell phones across this planet.
The FDA and the American Cancer Society disagree, saying there's no clear proof of significant risk. Consumers are becoming cautious.
These are relatively new. We don't know for sure. And there's probably a monetary incentive not to really find out.
It depends how much you speak on the phone. And there are some people who speak endlessly on the phone, so who knows?
I actually don't use it as much since my friend, she told me about this last year.
We went to this Milpitas laboratory, which tests cell phone safety in specially shielded rooms. Using a standardized plastic head, nicknamed Sam, and a special liquid that simulates brain tissue. Production cell phones are then set to full power and put up to Sam's ear. A probe measures the heating energy.
The FCC currently requires only the monitoring of the heating effect.
Strelo says there are at least two other effects, one on the human nervous system and a carcinogenic effect of radiation that are not tested.
Whenever I know I'm having a long phone conversation, I for example, use a headset.
Ellie Marks, by the way, still uses his cell phone, also with a headset.
This is the way we use our phones.
And European health officials now warn children to avoid using cell phones. The glow in this public service TV ad represents unseen radiation.
It's shocking to me that with all the good studies that are out there, and there are good studies, there are high-quality studies, that the United States government is not warning their citizens.
What promises to be the best study yet is expected later this month from the World Health Organization. Until then, the best advice may be to use common sense when you use your cell phone. Health and Science Editor John Fowler, KTVU, Channel 2 News.